I'm gonna go over here. I'm here at the park. Gonna do some walking. Got my magnetic water. Still drinking it. Got my magnetic bracelet on. Got a $3 lottery ticket here. Winner. I'm gonna go cash in after I get done walking. And give me some of my vitamin D. It's a nice day, but it's kind of a little bit cloudy. It's supposed to be 89 degrees today. Batman, you always get all the attention. Right, Chewie? That's a nice little Jeep. Little LED bar in the front of it. I wouldn't mind having something like that. They got a new guy working here at the park. I wonder what happened to the old guy. A lot of people walking here at the park today. I guess this beautiful weather brings out people. Getting that sunshine. It feels hotter than 72 degrees out right now. I see you peeking at me. Come here, you cute little fella, you. You cute little thing, you. I want to squeeze you. There's another cute little sucker. He's so cute, you. I was telling my wife the other day that there's this huge lizard that looks like a snake in my yard. And I've been seeing him the last 2 days. He's about, I don't know, 10 inches long. And he's like a rainbowish type of colors. And I told her, once you start seeing lizards come out, then you know the weather's going to start getting hotter. And the birds are very vocal today here at the park. I haven't seen any lizards here at the park yet, though. I've only been seeing them in my yard. I'm just riding here on this sidewalk. Somebody's been drawing over here chalk. The moon is shining right over there. Well, not shining, but it's out. You can barely see it. It looks really cool. It's got like clouds all around and stuff. I don't know if the camera will pick it up, but looks pretty cool. You can hear the bees buzzing like crazy in these trees. It's just a roar of bees buzzing. There's some kind of bumblebee there. It's like a humming in the air. The ground squirrel hasn't come out yet. I haven't seen it at all. Haven't seen any roadrunners yet either. That's what I liked about this park, is you always see 3 or 4 roadrunners running around. I haven't seen any big ravens yet either. Slowly but surely, the animals are coming out of hibernation now. This tree is just humming with bees. See if I can zoom in on some. The camera's gonna even pick this up. This whole tree, oh, Mr. Woodpecker, is just buzzing with bees. Just covered with bees. This guy's looking at me like, what is this guy filming? All these trees here, the ones that I have sinus problems with, are just covered with bees. That moon looks so cool up there. Where's that woodpecker? He's right here somewhere. The way that moon is looking in the sky, that reminds me of Star Wars movies. So, I went and visited my mother the other day. She's 79 years old, and she's healthy as a horse. Got a lot of energy, and I asked her, I said, Mom, when are you gonna get a cell phone, man? Because I came over a couple times and you weren't home. And she said, cell phones are rude. I said, cell phones are rude. She said, yeah, phones in general are rude. I said, why is that? She said, because nobody visits you if you have a cell phone or a telephone. People just call and they like to talk your ear off. And that's rude. I said, I still don't understand why it's rude. She goes, you don't know. They could be sitting in their underwear talking to you on the cell phone or your telephone. She doesn't own a TV either. She's never owned a TV. Except when we were kids, she had a TV. She had one of those big cabinet TVs that you open up. It was a record player. But she would only let us watch... what was it? Wildlife type TV shows. Or PBS, Sesame Street, stuff like that. She wouldn't let us watch the news or anything. I think that's where I get it from. Because I don't watch TV at all. I have TVs. I got 5 TVs in my house, but I don't watch TV. I only use them to watch movies. Or play video games. Or not video games, but PlayStation 4, or Xbox, something like that. Which I don't even do that anymore. My son does that. I just watch him. But, yeah, so I went over to visit her because she's a naturalist, an herbalist. She only takes herbal medicine. And I wanted to go tell her because she spends most of the day outside working in her yard, her gardens and stuff. And I wanted to go talk to her about this right here, my magnetic around my wrist and the magnetic water and stuff. And she like chewed me out for drinking water out of a plastic bottle. And she said, bottled water is bad for you. And I said, why? She goes, because there's fluoride in the water. I sound like her now. Her English is really bad. But she said, yeah, it's really bad. You should drink out of a glass. And I said, what do you mean drinking out of a glass? She said, drinking out of a glass is better than drinking out of a can or out of bottled water. So I said, where am I going to get a... I've been looking for glass bottles. She said, get a beer bottle, pour out the beer, wash it out, and then put your filtered water inside the beer bottle. Look at the flowers on these trees. I've never noticed these flowers before. Now, how come there's no bees flying around this tree? It's only when you get around these sinus problem trees. I think these are the mesquite trees. I think that's what they're called. But, yeah, there's another one right there. And another one. Man, I had some mini wheats for breakfast this morning. Man, it gave me a lot of freaking heartburn, gas. Oh, why is that? I've been burping like crazy. So I spent a couple hours talking to my mother. And I went over there because I wanted to talk to her about what I saw on YouTube about grounding or earthing. And to my surprise, when I got to her house, she was in her backyard working. But she's barefooted. And I was talking to my mom about this grounding that I've been seeing on the internet and YouTube. And she's like, I don't know why you sound amazed about it. I've been teaching all my children since you could walk to walk around barefooted. And now all of a sudden you think you just learned this from the internet. And I just started laughing because as she's telling me, I noticed that she's barefooted in her backyard. She's like, I raised 8 children and never once did I take you guys to the doctors because I never let you wear your shoes when you go outside. I always tell you to go outside, get some sun, play in the yard. And she's telling me that it's ringing a bell in my head of my memories of her telling me that. When we were kids, she's always telling us, go outside. It's too beautiful of a day to be indoors. If you want to be indoors, then grab the vacuum or go do the dishes in the kitchen and we would run outside. And she was telling me that she's never once taken us to the doctors. And I remember, I said, there was this one time you took me to the doctor. I broke my tooth and you took me to the dentist. Well, it's not really a dentist. I was about 16, maybe 17. She took me to Mexico, which is about an hour and a half south of Tucson, to cross the border back before you needed to have a passport to go into Mexico. She took me to an animal vet. it was a veterinarian slash doctor that when we were waiting there to get seen, which didn't take very long, it took about, once we got there, it took about 10 minutes, people sitting next to us holding chickens and pigs and stuff like this, like a funny scene you would see in a movie. And the doctor pulled my tooth with no pain, no shots, nothing. Pulled my tooth, told me to bite down on a piece of garlic and charged my mom $20. And that's the only kind of doctor that my mother has ever taken me to, or any of my brothers to, or sisters, my whole life. And I don't know why it is. I've known all this stuff growing up with my mom because she's part Indian, part Mexican. And I don't know, I think you just forget. You make yourself forget. Because all she ever gave us, she never gave us milk. Like, my stomach's hurting right now because I had a bowl of cereal and was, oh man, a lot of gas, a lot of burping, and stomach's hurting me. She never gave us milk unless we went and bought it freshly squeezed. There used to be a place here in Tucson you can go get freshly squeezed. You could even milk the cow yourself. And never had problems with milk, but I haven't had milk in a long time, man. My stomach's killing me. But, yeah, she said, walking around barefooted on the earth, Mother Nature, is the best medicine that God could ever give anyone. And nowadays, with the shoes that they put on your feet, with the rubber insulation and stuff, that disconnect you to Mother Nature, and the pharmaceutical companies poisoning you with prescriptions, and the hormones, the way she says hormones is funny. I can't do it like she says it, but it's so funny. The hormones that they give the chickens and the cows are poisoning everybody, making everybody sick. She said she's gonna be 80 soon. And she was telling me people are dying left and right before they even get to 50. And I had to remind her how old I'm gonna be, because she's got 8 kids and she don't remember every single one of us our names, let alone how old we are. And I said, my 53rd birthday is coming up. And she's like, wow, I'm surprised you live this long drinking that bottled water. So she's harping on me about bottled water, even though I got my magnets around it. She's like, yeah, she just laughed at that. But she's like, you should just go stand on your yard barefooted. That's the biggest magnet that you will ever find, and it's free. So after spending a couple hours of talking with my mother, I realize where I get my conspiracy theories and my ideas for natural medication. I get it from her. I'm gonna go over here and sit down and get some sun now. I'm done with my walking. Walked around 3 times. But wisdom from the older people in this world, if you just sit down and take time and listen to what they have to say, they have a lot of valuable knowledge. Look at this. So beautiful. There's a nest there too. I don't see anything in it though. That's another thing. I think it's the ones that make the tequila out of this aloe vera here. It's got that sprout coming up in the middle. There's a different type of aloe vera plant. My mom has all kinds of stuff, rocks like this, cactus, everything in her yard. Beautiful, but she didn't want me to do any filming. She thinks the camera is possessed with demons. I don't know, my mom is very clairvoyant type of woman. She has been doing things as a kid when we were kids that people are just now doing, like recycling, filtering your water through natural rocks and sand. She built her own filtration system with lava rocks, sand, dirt. And matter of fact, every time we get cut as a kid, she would grab a handful of, not like this top dirt right here, she would dig like a hole and get the dirt underneath. It's, you know, not dusty like this. Pack it onto whatever cut we have and then cover it, not with a band-aid, but with a sock or something, toilet tissue. And that was our Neosporin. Like today, my wife loves to use Neosporin. I'm gonna sit here and get some sun. But it's a little skate park here. Yeah. The knowledge of the older people in this generation, the older generation, they know a lot of stuff. And if people just take the time to, like I'm doing here, sit here and take in the beauty of Mother Nature and just listen to an older person about life. And I mean, really, really listen and absorb what they have to say to you. It's better than surfing on the internet. The two and a half hours I spent with my mom flew by. It felt like I was only there for 10 minutes. But yeah, I'm going to get my vitamin D here. I want to thank everybody for taking the time to watch my videos and listen to me talk and rant. But it's very important, man. Get out there. Explore Mother Nature. Take in her beauty and soak up them sun rays because you need them. Your body is a natural battery and needs to be recharged every day. That's my time. If you like this video, smash that like button. Don't forget to hit that subscribe. Don't cost anything. It's free. And time for me to recharge. Good, I'm gone.